Hello student, very good morning to all of you. I hope you all are happy, healthy and fine at home. And what did we discuss yesterday? Yesterday we discussed about the transhydroxylation. And in a transhydroxylation, which is a reagent used for the transhydroxylation, how the reaction proceed, what type of the stereochemistry, so that type of the thing we already learned. For transhydroxylation, suppose let us take as a starting material, we using there, that is alkene, further treated with per acid like as a performic acid, per acetic acid or per benzoic acid or metachloro per benzoic acid, these are the sum of the organic per acid, react with alkene and form one cyclic three-membered ether heterocyclic ring form there, and that ring is known as epoxide. Three-membered oxygen type of the ether ring is known as epoxide, and that process is known as epoxidation, and that epoxidation further hydrolyze, we are getting anti-addition type of the reaction and resulting into as a transhydroxylation, means anti-addition reaction takes place. And in the case of cis hydroxylation, we have learned the reagent used for cis hydroxylation is potassium permanganate or osmium tetroxide. Cyclic transition state is formed and produced as a cis addition type of the reaction, and there we have seen the stereochemistry, and in this case trans-2-butene produce the meso compound, and whereas cis-2-butene produce as a DL pair. So this type of the thing we discuss in the previous lecture. Today what we are going to learn is also as a very important as far as the exam point of view is concerned. The question appear on this topic, predict the product. So what here you require, you need to remember the starting material and the reagent, which reagent you are adding, and the product formation. So that are the point you should remember while predicting the product. And as I have told you that if you know the mechanism behind it, then and then you can able to predict the product. If you are not knowing the mechanism, you cannot directly predict the product. So you must know the mechanism behind it, then and then you can able to predict the product. That is the main basic requirement required for predicting the product as far as organic chemistry is concerned. So let's start today's discussion topic is a hydroboration oxidation. Hydroboration, hydro means hydrogen atom, boration means boron atom, and oxidation means oxidations take place. There is a, in terms of the organic chemistry, there is a addition of oxygen atom or hetero atom. That process is known as oxidation reaction, and reduction means what? In terms of the organic chemistry, I am talking specifically. So reduction means what? The what we can call it as a addition of hydrogen is known as a reduction reaction. So here is a oxidation. So here remember, hydroboration oxidation reaction. One reaction I am writing here. Let us see, as we know that generally we are referring only one unsymmetrical alkene here, because we are mainly talking about the alkene reactions only. So what are the type of the reaction they produce or they gives or yield, that we are learning. So let us take the simplest starting compound, CH3CH double bond CH2. This is the alkene and this one is unsymmetrical, so that formation of the product, whether it is a major or minor, for that purpose we are considering here the propylene. This is a propylene, right? Propylene, that is the name of this compound, or we can call it propene, right? Now first one, it is treated with B2S6 in presence of THF. THF is called as a what we can call it as, it is a tetrahydrofuran. So this is the first reagent adding B2X6, or this B2X6 is called as a diborane. This is known as a diborane, or this B2X6 we can write here BH3 twice. One and the same thing, B2S6 in presence of TH, the full form of TF is a tetrahydrofuran. The full form of this is a tetrahydrofuran. That is the full form of that, and it is used as a solvent in this particular reaction. And the structure of this tetrahydrofuran is this one. Furan structure, we know that furan, analog of this, we know that this is a structure of furan, heterocyclic chemistry. In SYBSC you have learned this. This is a structure of furan, and this furan is aromatic in nature, and as we know that aromatic compound has a special stability. They have certain characteristic features of this aromatic compound. So you already know that. I am not going to go into the detail of it, but here just remember, as a tetrahydrofuran, this is a structure, this is aromatic, this becomes as a non-aromatic. And as we know that aromatic means what, it obeys as a Hückel's rule. There are criteria, fully conjugated, planar, and the cyclic. So that type of the compound is termed as a aromatic compound, and they has the extra stability than this. So that energy is called as a stabilization energy. I think it has a 36 kilocalorie per mole. That much amount of the stabilization energy associated with the that is there. And now second reagent treated with H2O2 in presence of OH minus. And as we know that OH minus means, where from this OH minus is coming, similar to, suppose this is written as a H plus. In organic chemistry generally we are writing H plus and the OH minus. Always remember, H plus means it may coming from inorganic acid or the organic acid. Inorganic acid generally from HCl, HNO3 or H2SO4, or maybe from acetic acid or benzoic acid, this CH means. And OH means what? It is coming from the bases, generally sodium hydroxide, potassium hydroxide, aluminium hydroxide, or that type of the here you remember that hydroxy is coming from, or this is known as alkaline medium, which that alkaline medium OH minus. So and after adding all these reagents into this substrate, this is a starting compound, this is a reagent we are adding one after one, the resulting compound formed, and the compound is formed CH3, CH2, CH2, and the OH. there is a formation of the alcohol. If you observe the structure carefully, what do you get? The compound form, which is exactly opposite to the Markovnikov's rule, or it is a like anti-Markovnik type of the compound. Means this is a one of the best method for the synthesis of alcohol, that less substituted alkene at as that OH group over here. So that is a speciality. This is a very good method for the synthesis of alcohol. This is a laboratory method or industrial method for the synthesis of this type of the alcohol in the industry or in generally there. So look at, this is a general reaction. When predict the product, this treated with this reagent, we are getting as a this product. Why I am writing as a this product? Because I know the mechanism behind it. That's why I am writing as a mechanism there. If I am not knowing as a mechanism, I cannot predict that product. I know the mechanism behind it, and that's why I am predicting that. And let us look at how the mechanism takes place over here. So that we are going to see here. Mechanism. Look at the mechanism carefully. Observe the mechanism carefully. Now here, what is happening? This is CH3, then CH, double bond CH2, and then here it is treated with BH3, one monomer you can take over here. So this is a diborane, means this one, so you can take as a monomer. Here hydrogen atom, here hydrogen atom, they are in a trigonal panel. And here, as we know that beta, boron, B means boron atom, it is a Lewis acid, and there is a empty p orbital available here, an empty p orbital, and that's why it act as a electrophilic in nature. And this, as we know that it is a electrophile in nature, and therefore these double bond attacking on that boron atom, at the same time that hydrogen atom, now here is a hydride transfer. Again, remember here H plus, we know that it is a proton, right? It is known as a proton. H plus means proton, and where H minus, it is called as a hydride. It is known as a hydride. Hydride means negatively charged hydrogen atom are called as a hydride, and positively charged hydrogen atom are called as a proton. Remember these two terms frequently we are using in the organic chemistry. Here in this particular example, this this hydrogen atom taking its bonding pair along with and attacking on this carbon atom, because when this double bond forming the bond with that boron atom, then there is a formation of one transition state is formed here. There is no formation of the cation in this case, and no rearrangement reaction possible in this case. Only that hydrides are transferred and form the state that is called as the transition state. And transition state, how we can show as a transition state over here? Here you can write for sake of convenience, this methyl group you can write over there, hydrogen atom you can write, one of the bond we can write here, then the hydrogen atom here, another hydrogen atom. Now here is a dotted line, means this hydrogen atom, hydride atom transfer from here to here attacking, means the bond is going to form there, and that's why I have shown that bond dotted line. Now what is going to happen here? The bond is going to form between this boron atom, and the bond between this hydrogen and boron atom also going to break. This bond is going to break, this is going to form, this bond is going to form again, and this hydrogen atom they are as it is, and that's why I have shown this transition state here, because in this case what is happening here, it act as a minus delta charge, here act as a partial, this boron gets as a partial positive charge, partial positive charge because there is a empty p orbital present in that boron atom, and that hydride gets the minus negative, and therefore this type of the transition states are formed. And now when that, this is called as a transition state, and that transition state is a short lived, further it is collapses into the product. The product formed here like this, CH3, then CH2, one hydrogen from here, then CH2, then boron, one hydrogen from here and one hydrogen, they are remains as it. So this is a one hydrogen atom get replaced by this alkyl group. Remember, the here the three moles of this alkene reacted with this reagent and form as a three moles of alcohol. Remember, three equivalent of that molecule form over there. Now here this one, you can remember here I am taking here this CH3CH2, this one, or let us see, keep as it is. So for sake of convenience we can write here CH3CH double bond CH2. Look at, can you see this structure? Okay, this olipin, again this hydrogen atom transfer from here to add this carbon atom, and this double bond is going to attack on that boron, and we are going to get the product here CH3, then CH2, CH2, boron, one hydrogen atom here, now this one CH2, CH2, and this one is another CH3, right? Now again what is going to happen, again this is a first mole, right? One alkene, second alkene, now is a third alkene. Let us see here CH3, CH double bond CH2. Now here what is going to happen, this hydrogen atom transferring from here to here, and this double bond is going to attack on that boron atom. What do you get? In short, we will get B, and I am writing here let R is equal to nothing but as a CH2, CH2 and the CH3 I am considering here. So here what should I get? Here I am getting as a R, here also R, and here also as a R, 3R. R is nothing but as a get substituted by the propyl group. This is a propyl group. Let R is equal to CH2, CH2 and the CH3. So we got here trialkyl borane. This is known as a trialkyl borane. Trialkyl borane. Now again it will react with this species, this hydro H2O2. As you know that H2O2, what is the chemical name of H2O2? I think in the previous chapter number 2 or maybe on a chapter number 3, we already heard about this chemical, that is a H2O2 is a hydrogen peroxide. It has a medicinal properties are there, that I think we already know that. Now it is reacting with HOO-, means that alkali becoming as a hydrogen peroxide written as HO, O and H. OH minus will pick up this proton and form as a this type of the species over there. And now what is going to happen? Still this boron is containing empty p orbital, and therefore this negative charge is going to attack on that boron, and after attacking as a, on a boron, what do you get? You get here B, here is R, here R, one R you can write here O, O and H, like this. This type, now look at here, boron has a 3 bond, now here is a 4 bond, and therefore there is a negative charge develop on, it can tolerate that negative charge because it has a empty p orbital. And now this R group shifting from here to here, and there is a removal of OH, there is a something arrangement, a rearrangement type of the reaction takes place. This R group get migrate on that oxygen atom, and we are going to get here R. Look at here B, then here we can write O R, and another R already here, right? This type of the thing is getting over. Are you getting this now? Okay, here again one more O, then O H. This negatively attacking on that boron atom, you are going to get here again B. It is O R, you can write here. This is R, here R, O and O H. And this R now is going to attack on that, there is a negative charge on the boron atom, and then OH get removed, and so that you are going to get here B, then OR here, this R still there, and there is a OR, right? Now another one, O minus O and H, 3, here is 1, 2 and 3 again going to attack over there, and you are going to get here B O R. I am writing here is a O R, here is a R, then O O H, right? Now again this R, third R now, here is a negative charge, third R attacking on that oxygen OH get removed, and what do you get here? You are going to get here is a B, then here you are going to get B over here, B O R O R, and here O R, 3 O R, and that treated with 3 O H minus, 3 equivalent of hydroxy, and what is going to happen? This is going to attack over there, removal of this, and you will get as a 3 R O H and plus B O H thrice like this. Finally we are getting, and as we know that R is nothing but as a this one CH3 CH2 CH2 and the OH. That's the mechanism of hydroboration oxidation reaction. This is a Lindy mechanism. Mechanism is not at your PYBSC level, just the predict the product, how the products are coming. If you do this mechanism once or twice, and as we know that one saying is there or proverb is there, a man practice makes perfect. So do practice mechanism on your, you might be having as a rough notebook, on that you can do once or twice, you will be very well on that things mechanism, because it needed as a practice. If you do more practice, more will be the benefit, because everything is depend upon the hard working. So if you study hard, you will be you will pass in a exam. So that is a main principle or basic thing behind it. So remember, this is a mechanism over there how we are. Now let us look at some of the application or by the example I am going to take over here. Now here just remember how do you get this one. So now first example I am considering, examples are here. Let us see here CH3, then CH3 double bond CH2, that will be treated with B2H6 in presence of THF A product, and then treated with H2O2 in presence of O minus and the B product. How do you predict the product? Because you know that the mechanism right now, right? So once you know the mechanism, predict the product, it's very easy, because you are knowing the mechanism behind it. Now here what is going to happen? Here as we know that boron atom and the hydrogen atom, the boron attached to those carbon atom, boron atom add according to as a Marconi Cope's rule. What the Marconi Cope's rule tells that in an addition reaction, negative part of the reagent or addendum attached to those carbon atom which has less number of hydrogen atom. In this particular case, what is happening here? Boron hydrogen atom is a minus delta charge and boron is a plus delta charge. Therefore, this is a negatively charged, and according to the Markovnikov's rule, what do you get over there? The product will be CS3, then CH3H, then CH2 boron, and this line clearly indicate that such type of the group present over there. So that is the meaning. A product you have to write like this in the exam. It clearly indicate that this type of the isobutyl group must be there. So that is the meaning of this two lines, right? And now H2O2O, and all these three get replaced, and the B product, main product, don't think about the side product. Now here is a main product we are going to get here, CS3, then CH, CS3, then CH2 and the OH. This is the main product we are getting in this. Are you getting this? Okay. Now, can you tell me the correct IUPAC name of this compound? Now, OH, as we know that it is a functional group, where from which side I should number this carbon chain, the numbering start from the hydroxy side, means 1, 2, 3, at 2 position methyl group is there, so 2 methyl, 1 propanol, 1, 2, write as a 1 or not, if 2 methyl propanol, that is a steel, or you can write 1 methyl, 1 propanol, that is there. Now, let us look at as another, this is a first example, second example. Let us see here, CS3, then CH, then CH3, double bond here. And now, what will be the IUPAC name of this in the first example? 1, 2, 3, right? 1, 2, 3, at 2 position, there is a methyl group, and therefore the IUPAC name of this compound is a 2-methyl, 1-propene. So that is the IUPAC name of this compound. And now, what will be the IUPAC name of this compound? 1, 2, 3, 4. At 2 position, 1, 2, 3, and 4. At 2 position, there is a methyl group, and therefore 2-methyl, at 2 position, there is a carbon-carbon double bond, therefore 2-butene. Last suffix is a E and E, clearly indicate that organic compound containing carbon-carbon double bond. And now, the treated with this one, BH3 twice in presence of THF, tetrahydrofuran. You can write B2S6, that is a diborane. This is also as a diborane. Don't get confused, because sometime in the exam, it may be printed like this, B2S6, or maybe as a BH3 twice. So if you multiply by this with this boron or H2, we will get as a this diborane species. And now, what do you get here? A product should be this one, CHB, you can write there, then CH, CS3 and the CS3. This B indicate that is called as a hydro, and now remember this step is a hydroboration. This is known as a hydroboration process. First step is a hydroboration. Hydro means hydrogen and the boron atom added across the carbon-carbon double bond, and that's why it is called as a hydroboration. And oxidation means what? Removal of this. This one is a oxidation reaction. Oxidation with the H2O2, and we are getting as a formation of the alcohol over there. Now, there this bond is going to break, and you are going to get here H2O2 in presence of OH. Finally, that boron atom get replaced by hydroxy group. That is the basic principle you should remember here. CH3, CHOH, then here CH, then CH3 and the CH3. That is, what will be the IUPAC name of this compound? Can you tell me? Yes. 1, 2, 3 and 4. At 2, 3 position there is a methyl group, and 2 position there is a hydroxy group, and therefore the IUPAC name of this compound will be this one, 3-methyl 2-butanol. Why butanol? Because but indicate as a 4 carbon atom in the straight chain, and therefore that is the IUPAC name of that compound. Got it? Now let us see one more example here. Suppose we have a double bond here. Now it is treated with BH3 twice in presence of THF. This is the first one, and second one will be what we can call it. Second one is 2O2 in presence of OH. Directly you predict the product. If you add both reagent, one after that you write second, it means that the predict the product means you have to write the final product here in this particular case. And as we know that here, according to as anti-Markovnikov's rule, alcohol is we are getting. Look at here, anti-Markovnikov's rule. Remember in this case, but here is a Markovnikov rule. Here a product where is a Markovnikov's rule you remember, but while final product you should remember the product are obtaining according to as a anti-Markovnikov's rule. And here the syn addition reaction takes place. Syn addition reaction means what? Both the in the mechanism we forgot to explain this point. Syn addition means what? Hydrogen atom and the boron atom, they are coming on the same side of the carbon-carbon double bond, and that type of the addition is called as a syn addition. In a hydroxylation, cis hydroxylation and the trans hydroxylation, there we have seen this such type of the stereochemistry. Here also remember it is a syn addition. And now look at here, carbon-carbon double bond, where should I put the OH? I should put the OH group, hydroxy group, either this carbon atom or this carbon atom. First of all, tell me the correct IUPAC name of this compound. Observe this structure carefully. Look at, this is a cycle is there, 5 carbon atom in the cycle, and one branching is there. So start the numbering from branching 1, 2, not from this side, because double bond is this side. So you should give the number from this side, 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5, and the name of this compound is a 1-methyl cyclobutene. Last suffix is a ene, prefix is a ene, that clearly indicate there will be a carbon-carbon double bond. And finally you are going to get the product here in this case, like this. OH must be here, so this is the final product you are getting. And what will be the IUPAC name of this compound? Again, here is a OH group is a functional group, and as we know that functional group, so numbers start from this side, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and therefore the name of this compound is a 1-cyclopentanol. So that is the IUPAC name of this compound. I think with this we have completed this hydroboration oxidation reaction. I know that there will be a no doubt, we have learned the mechanism why we are getting as a, this is a one of the classical method for the synthesis of the alcohol, but the alcohol obtained according to as a anti-Markovnikov's rule. That is the thing you have to remember, and you remember the reagent used for it as a hydroboration. hydroboration, that is a B2XCs, diboron is used over there in presence of tetrahydrofuran as a solvent, and in the second oxidation occur in presence of the hydrogen peroxide and the in alkaline medium, generally as a OH minus. I think with this, let us in the next lecture, tomorrow's lecture, we will learn about the remaining, that is a hydrogenation, or what we can call it as the formation of the alkane. With this, let us wrap up this lecture here. Thank you. Have a nice day.